Hello, I'm Kelly O'Byrne and welcome to LCG's preview for the week ahead. I'll be discussing the long-awaited meeting between Presidents Trump and Putin, US earnings season, Chinese economic growth and the sudden drop in the price of oil. Before that though, I'll run down some of the top corporate results to watch for this week. Bank of America and Netflix report second quarter earnings on Monday. Sandvik, Johnson & Johnson and Goldman Sachs report quarterly results on Tuesday. Novartis, Electrolux, Morgan Stanley, IBM and eBay report second quarter numbers on Wednesday. On Thursday, it's Unilever and Publicis reporting half-year results. Sports Direct offer up full-year results and Volvo, Domino's Pizza, Microsoft release second quarter earnings. Finally, on Friday, General Electric report second quarter earnings. Now, moving on to the economic calendar, on Monday, there is China's second quarter GDP, as well as retail sales and industrial production, US retail sales and the Trump-Putin meeting. On Tuesday, there is UK unemployment and average earnings, followed by US industrial production. On Wednesday, we have UK inflation, Eurozone CPI and the Fed's beige book. On Thursday, it's Australian unemployment and UK retail sales. Then on Friday, we round off the week with Japanese inflation and Canadian CPI. So Jasper's away this week, so I'll go over some of the key topics the LCG research team are covering. Markets seem to have moved on from Russiagate with no evidence of collusion between Trump and Russia after months of investigation by Robert Mueller. Still, the tension between the US and Russia, in part because of the accusation of Russian meddling in US election, means the meeting will be widely watched. Any sign of a thaw in the frosty relationship should be a good thing for global geopolitical risk. Now, can US earnings overcome political risk to send equities higher again in the summer? This is the question we address on the LCG Markets Report page. Momentum is expected to continue with the ongoing benefits from US tax cuts and recently released economic data adding to investor confidence. Moving on to China, GDP data for the second quarter will be a clue for investors about how well China's economy is positioned to handle the new US tariffs. Since the tariffs were only enacted at the end of the quarter, there is unlikely to be any direct impact yet. Finally, last week saw a dramatic 6% one-day decline in the price of oil. These sudden price moves are often a sign of capitulation, in this case by the bulls. There is room for some short-term recovery, but we suspect Brent crude has put in a double top at $80 a barrel. This could imply oil will ultimately be heading lower over the coming weeks. Thank you very much for watching. As usual, if you wish to see these videos as soon as they're released, please follow LCG on YouTube and social media.